Good morning all. Today we are going to discuss about the star connected load. So this star connected load can be two types. Either it will have a four-wire system or a three-wire system. The three-wire system means it will have an isolated neutral connection. That means there will be no neutral wire. Only we can connect the line voltages only. We cannot connect the phase loads, or across any one particular phase we cannot take the load. So I am going to solve this first, so that the second analysis will be very easy, that we will see in the end. So I am assuming my supply is there, that supply is having a neutral connection. Each supply is producing a voltage VAN, VBN and VCN. So as a result of this, the line voltage will be equal to VAB, VBC and VCA. We always assume the supply is balanced. That means the sum of phasor sum of the phase voltages or the line voltages will always be equal to zero. But the currents may or may not be equal to zero. They depend on the load. So let us assume this load is having, because three loads are connected, let us assume their center point or the neutral point for them is equal to zero. That means point where the voltage will be equal to zero. So this will be plus minus and the plus minus, because current is entering. Let us assume, because in this the current entering is equal to IA, in this the current entering is IB, in this the current entering is IC. So, and I am also assuming my supply is balanced. So supply is balanced, so this will be like this. This will be value of A, B and C. So this is my value of the neutral. Always, because supply is balanced, the line cannot change. That means the tips A, B and C cannot change. Let us assume the secondary is displaced by some angle. That means O is not intersecting or coinciding with N. Let us assume this is my respective phase voltages VAO. This will be VBO and VCO. This is for the case of secondary because of the load. This is VAO, VBO, VCO. So I want to know whether it will really shift. If it is shifting, how much it will shift, and why the voltages are different in different phases. That I am going to derive in the simplest possible way. So let us see this. So if I am going to the circuit or the load, you can get here the current IA is entering, IB is entering, IC is entering. If you take at node O, the current entering should be equal to current leaving, or I can tell that the sum of the currents, that means IA plus IB plus IC should be equal to zero, because it should satisfy the KCL. Or I can write that the value of IA, IA is nothing but the voltage applied across it divided by impedance, or 1 by impedance is equal to admittance. We have already studied before. So I am directly writing it. This is VAO, voltage between A and O, or voltage across that impedance multiplied by the admittance, plus VBO multiplied by YB plus VCO multiplied by YC should be equal to 0. Let us take this as equation number 1. So now I can calculate my value of VAO. This VAO I can write as VAN plus VNO. VAN means the value of A is positive with respect to N. So similarly, VNO means I am assuming this is plus and this is minus. I am just applying the KVL in this loop. So if you apply the KVL, you will get this VAN plus VNO will be equal to, because this is opposite, this is plus minus, so will be equal to VAO. So VAN plus VNO is equal to VAO. I have written that only. I hope this is clear. So let us take this as equation number 2. So similar way I can write the other equations. The value of VBO will be equal to VBN plus VNO. I am taking this as equation number 2. Similarly, third equation I can write as VCO is equal to VCN plus VNO. This I am taking as equation number. So this is number equation number 3, this is equation number 4, sorry. So now, using equation number 2, 3 and 4, equation number 1 can be written as, I am just substituting the value of VAO, VBO and VCO in that equation. So if you substitute this, this will become VAN plus VNO times of YA plus VBN plus VNO times of YB plus VCN plus VNO times of YC is equal to 0. So this is what we get. Or from this I can further simplify, or this VNO I am taking out, VNO if you take out, this becomes YA plus YB plus YC. This will be equal to minus VAN into YA plus VBN into YB plus VCN into YC. This is what we get. Or from this I can calculate VNO is equal to minus VAN into YA plus VBN into YB plus VCN into YC divided by YA plus YB plus YC. This is what we get. So we are getting it as a negative. So getting it as a negative, I want to represent in the positive value. So I can just write VNO is nothing but minus VON. That means voltage between point N and O, if I am taking this as plus and minus, this is equal to, if you are taking this as plus and this as minus, it will be opposite. So same thing I am representing. I can write my value of VON. Just reverse this. This will become plus. So VAN into YA plus VBN into YB plus VCN into YC divided by YA plus YB plus YC. So this is my value of the shift between the point N and O. That means the source and the load. So once you've obtained this, so I can calculate my value of VA naught. That means phase voltage or the voltage across the impedance 1 will be equal to VAN, phase voltage of your supply, minus VON. What is the shift? Previously I have written plus VNO because now I am taking the sign opposite, so it becomes minus VON. Similarly, VBO will be equal to VBN minus VON. Similarly, VCO is equal to VCN minus VON. So once you get these voltages, so automatically I can calculate my currents. So currents I can calculate as the value of IA will be equal to VAO divided by Z1 or VAO multiplied by Y1. So similarly, IB I can calculate VBO multiplied by Y2. So similarly, IC I can calculate as VCO multiplied by Y3 or YC, whatever is there, the third admittance. So in this way I can calculate. So let us see the case when all the admittances are same or it is a balanced load, what will be the resultant? How much shift will be there between the neutral points? So I can substitute here the value of YA is equal to YB is equal to YC is equal to Y. That means I am taking the case of balanced load. If I am taking the balanced load, YA is equal to YB is equal to YC is equal to, let us assume Y. So I can substitute in this, the value of VON will be equal to VAN plus VBN plus VCN multiplied by Y divided by 3 times of Y. So we know the sum of VAN plus VBN plus VCN, this value, because supply is always balanced, this value becomes equal to 0. Or I can tell the phase shift between the supply neutral and your load neutral is 0. That means both are having at the same potential. When N and V are at the same potential, the current passing through them is 0. Or I can tell in my supply as well as in the load, always the voltage across each load will be equal to phase voltage only. It is not going to affect. Whereas when the supply is not balanced, there will be a component of VON with some angle. So automatically, depending on the impedance of different phases will have the different voltage and your supply becomes unbalanced. To clarify this further, we will take the example, and in the example I am going to solve. So this is one way to solve, either calculating VON and calculating. There are some more other methods, because if you are referring from books, so you will get some other techniques also. So some other techniques are the technique 2. Either you can calculate with this. There is second technique also. You can do star to delta conversion, because this is easiest out of all. So let us see how to do this. So there is a star connection. This is my star connection. Let us assume this is my value of ZA, ZB, ZC. These are my terminals A, B, C. So this I can convert to equivalent delta connection. So how to convert to the equivalent delta connection? So this is same thing like what you have studied in networks. So the value of this impedance will be ZAB. ZAB will be equal to ZA plus ZB plus ZA ZB divided by ZC. So similarly, I can calculate this value. This value is connected between B and C. ZBC will be equal to the sum of the impedance that are connected, ZB plus ZC plus product of them divided by the third impedance. Third impedance will be ZA. Similarly, I can calculate my value of ZCA is equal to ZC plus ZA plus ZC ZA divided by ZB. So once the impedances are obtained, so this will convert to equivalent delta connection. Remember here, whenever you are doing star to delta or delta to star conversion, the basic will remember that the line currents or the line voltages will not change. Even the line impedance across two lines will not change. So automatically using this impedance, so using this delta connection, I can calculate my value of IA, IB and IC. Once I calculate the value of IC and IC, because we know same current will pass through this phase, because in the case of star connection, line current is equal to phase current. So once this current is obtained, if I want to calculate the voltage VAO, let us take this point as O, VAO will be equal to this IA calculated using delta connection divided by or multiplied by ZA. So this is the value. Same way I can calculate the value of the other voltage drops also. So out of all the techniques, this technique will be so much flexible. So generally we prefer to go for star to delta conversion and do it. But sometimes the calculation may become little cumbersome if we are not comfortable. So there is another way of doing this. Another way of doing this is, you have a star connection. This is the star connection. This is phase A. Let us assume this is phase B, this is phase C. So this is the value of ZA, ZB and ZC. So you can apply the loop current method. So you can apply in this loop. So in this loop, the voltage will be equal to VAC. So you apply this. So take another loop, calculate it. Take another loop which is passing like this. So calculate this. So applying the loop voltage method or Maxwell's loop current method, you can calculate the value. So this is also another technique. So application of a particular technique depends on what is the flexibility of the person in which you are so much comfortable. You can apply the Maxwell's mesh current analysis and you can even get from that. So generally I prefer either the first derivation what I did, either you can calculate VON, which is very easy to calculate, or you can go for star delta conversion. So let us see the case of second one. That means star connected load with four wires. That means the neutral wire is also connected. So if neutral is connected, so your supply will be like this. So there is one neutral point also. So this is connected to my load. So this is my value of A, B and C. These neutral points are connected together. So this is my A, B and C. So you can see here, as the neutral points are connected together, if you neglect the value of this resistance of this neutral wire, always we can tell that the value of VAN will be equal to VAO. So what I mean to tell, irrespective of what is the condition of the other impedances, the current passing through any phase will only depend on impedance of that phase. Let us assume this phase has impedance of ZA, this will always be equal to VAN. Because if you are neglecting the voltage drop in this resistance, so we can tell that always the current through this will be equal to VAN divided by ZA. Similar is the case for other phases, so there is no problem. And let us assume the currents are unbalanced, so some of the currents that are entering here, that will return back through this neutral wire. So this will become IN is equal to IA plus IB plus IC. That means whatever is the sum of the currents that can return back through your neutral wire. So that's why there will be no shifting of your neutral. Your neutral will always be stabilized. Or in this case, the value of VON will become equal to zero. Because the sum of the currents, because when I am calculating the VAN, I have taken IA plus IB plus IC is equal to zero, because there is no return path for the current. But in this case, that IA plus IB plus IC, because IA will enter like this, IB will enter from here, IC will enter from here, the sum of the currents can return back through your neutral. So that is the reason when you are connecting the three phase four wire system, the analysis is so much easy, no need to worry. Directly you can analyze either phase value based or the line value based. There will be no shifting in the neutral. That will be the advantage. So let us take some examples to clarify about what we have discussed, because without examples there is no use of discussing the things. So first I am taking an unbalanced 4 wire star connected load has a balanced voltage of 400 volts. The loads are given Z1 is equal to 4 plus J8, Z2 is equal to 3 plus J4 and Z3 is equal to 15 plus J20. Calculate line current, current in neutral wire, and last one, the total power. That is what is asked. So let us try to solve this. So to solve this, first thing is you have to note down what is the given data. So given data is, first impedances are given there. So Z is equal to 4 plus J8. Let us convert to the polar form, because we don't know which form will be convenient to solve in a particular case. So 63.4. Similarly, the value of Z2 is 3 plus J4. So this I can write as 5 at an angle of 53.1. And similarly, the value of Z3 is given as 15 plus J20. This will be equal to 25 at an angle of 53.12 degrees. So let us take the value of, because it is a star connection, I told you when the neutral is connected, you can analyze either based on the phase values or the line values. So let us analyze with the phase values because it is easy. So I want to calculate the value of phase value of the R phase. So this will become 400 by root 3. So this will become equal to 230.94. This I am taking as my reference. So similarly, I can calculate my value of YN will be equal to 230.94 at an angle of minus 120 degrees. Similarly, I can take my VBN will be equal to 230.94 at an angle of minus 240 degrees. So once these are obtained, I can calculate my current in each phase. Current in each phase will be equal to voltage across that phase divided by the impedance. So this will become VRN divided by Z1. This will be equal to 230.94 at an angle of 0 degrees divided by 8.94 at an angle of 63.4, because we know it is easier to divide or multiply using polar form. So that's why I have used the polar form. This will become 25.83 at an angle of minus 63.4 degrees, or this I can write as 11.56 minus J 23.09. So similar way, I can calculate my value of IY. IY will be equal to VYN divided by Z2. This will be equal to 230.94 at an angle of minus 120 divided by 5 at an angle of 53.1. So this will become 46.188 at an angle of minus 173.1, or this will be equal to 45.85 minus J 5.54. So similarly, I can calculate my value of IB. IB is equal to VBN divided by Z3, 330.94 at an angle of minus 240 divided by 25 at an angle of 53.13. This will become 9.23 at an angle of 293.13 degrees, or this will be 3.62 plus J 8.48. So these are obtained. So now I can easily calculate my value of the neutral current. The value of the neutral current will be IR plus IY plus IB. Take the phasor sum. So if you take the phasor sum, because whenever you want to add, adding the rectangular coordinate system is easy. So you add the X component and you add the imaginary component. So this will become 30.67 plus J 20.15, or this I can write as 36.69 at an angle of 33.3 degrees. This is my neutral current. So now the last one, it is asked, what is the total power? Total power, I told you, I prefer the multiplication of V into I into cos of the angle, but you can even go with I square into R of the respective. So if you know the resistance component, that means take the impedance. Impedance you represent in the rectangular coordinate system, the real component indicates the resistance. So you can take the whatever is the current that is coming, I square into that resistance. Using that also you can calculate, because in that case that is also easy. So I prefer the value of VR and V into I into cos phi. So you can substitute the value. So let us take, for example, this will become VRN IRN into cos phi R plus, let us try to solve with both, IYN into cos phi Y plus VBN IBN into cos phi BN plus this VCN ICN into cos phi C. So this will become 230.94 into 25.83 into cos of the angle between voltage and current. If you take cos of the angle, this will become 63.4 plus 230.94 into 46.188 into cos of voltage angle is minus 120 minus of minus 173.1. So this is the second one. So the third one will become 230.94 into 9.23 into cos of minus 240 plus 293.13. So if you take this, you will get is 2670.96 plus 6404.47 plus 1278.94. So if you take this sum, you will get 10354.94. 37 watts. This is one way. So let us follow the second technique. Second technique means multiplying I square into R, I1 square R1, then I2 square R2 plus I3 square into R3. So let us take the first current. So first current is nothing but IR. So the value of IR we got as 25.83. So I am taking that. This is 25.83 whole square into resistance 1. From the Z1 is equal to 4 plus J8. So I can take 4 as my resistance plus I2 square. The value of I2 we have obtained, the value of IY is 46.188. So this will be equal to 46.188 square into 3 plus the third current. The third current we got as 9.23 whole square into 15. So if you calculate this again, you will get the same thing, 10,354.37. You can please cross verify with the calculator. So whichever is comfortable to you, you can follow any one of these techniques. So let us take another example to completely clarify the remaining two concepts. That means the first and the second technique we have discussed. So I am taking another example, a 400 volts 3-phase supply feeds an unbalanced 3-phase 3-wire star connected load. The branch impedances of the load are ZR is equal to 4 plus J8 ohms, ZY is equal to 3 plus J4 ohms, and ZB is equal to 15 plus J20 ohms. Find the line currents and voltage across each phase impedance. Assume RYB phase sequence. This is what is asked. So here it is given, it is an unbalanced load, 3-phase 3-wire system. 3-phase 3-wire system means it is not 4-wire, so different phases will have different value of voltage. So only technique available to us, either we can solve with star to delta conversion, or we can go with the first method of analysis which we have discussed. So let us see each one of them. So first I am going with star to delta conversion. So let us try to start with star to delta conversion. So let us write the impedances once again. The value of ZR is given as 4 plus J8. So this I can write as 8.954 at an angle of 63.4 degrees. ZY is equal to 3 plus J4. This will become 5 at an angle of 53.1 degrees. And ZB will be equal to 15 plus J20. This will become 25 at an angle of 53.1 degrees. Let us assume when the star is connected to equivalent delta. So this is my delta connection. So let us take this as R, Y and B. So this will become Z, R, Y, Z, Y, B and Z, B, R. So let us assume because of this the current passing is I, R, Y, I, Y, B. This will become I, B, R. This is my value of I, R. This is my value of I, Y. This is my value of IB. I need to calculate line currents. This is my target. So now to calculate star to delta conversion, how to calculate the value of ZRY. So we have already seen to calculate the ZRY, I have to take ZR plus ZY plus ZR into ZY divided by the third one. Third one will be B. So if you substitute this, because add these two, multiply divided by the reason. If you do this, I am directly writing the answer to save the time. 15.67 at an angle of 60.13 degrees. Similarly, I can calculate my value of ZYB. ZYB will be equal to ZY plus ZB plus ZY into ZB divided by ZR. So if you substitute this, you will get as 43.83 at an angle of 49.83 degrees. So similarly, I can calculate my value of ZBR will be equal to ZB plus ZR plus ZB ZR divided by ZY. This will be equal to 78.36 at an angle of 60.13 degrees. So I have to take some voltage as my reference. Let us take my value of VRY. I am taking as my reference. So line voltage is given as 400. I am taking as 400 at an angle of 0. Similarly, this VYB, I am taking as 400 at an angle of minus 120 degrees. Similarly, VBR, I can take as 400 at an angle of minus 240 degrees. So now I can calculate my respective current that is passing through phase. IRY is VRY divided by ZRY. So if you divide this, you will get as 25.52 at an angle of 60.13. Similarly, I can calculate IYB will be equal to VYB divided by ZYB. This will become equal to 9.12 at an angle of minus 169.83 degrees. Similarly, I can calculate my value of IBR is equal to VBR divided by ZBR. It is 5.10 at an angle of minus 300.13 degrees. So these are what are obtained. So once the phase currents are obtained, I can calculate my line current. IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. So similar way, I can calculate the other line current. So I am calculating my line currents. The IR is equal to IRY minus IBR. So if you calculate this, you will get is a 28.41 at an angle of minus 69.07. Similarly, I can calculate my value of IY, which will be equal to IYB minus IRY. This is 29.85 at an angle of 136.58 degrees. Similarly, I can calculate my value of IB. IB is IBR minus IYB. So this you will get as 13 at an angle of 27.6. So once you get the line current, so same current will pass through the phase of your star. So now I am going back to the star connection. So now I can calculate my value of the impedance, the passing through the impedance of the star connection. So across the impedance, so I can calculate my value of the voltage that is passing across the impedance. So VRO. So I can calculate as IR into the value of ZR. So IR into ZR will be 253.89 into minus 5.67. Remember, here I have to take ZR, the star connected impedance. So similarly, I can calculate my value of VY0 will be equal to IY into ZY. This will be 149.2 at an angle of 189.68 degrees. Similarly, the value of VBO will be equal to IB into ZB. This will be equal to 325 at an angle of 80.7 degrees. You can observe here, each of the phase impedance, the value of this voltage across the respective impedances has completely changed. And it is also observed that whichever impedance is having the more value, more voltage is dropping across that impedance, because the impedance value of ZB is equal to 15 plus J20. So across that maximum voltage is dropped, and whichever impedance is minimum, the minimum value of impedance wherever is there, that impedance have the minimum value of the voltage. So whichever impedance is more, more voltage is dropped. Whichever impedance is less, the less voltage is dropped. The reason is because the value of current passing through any impedance is depending on the impedances of other phases. That is the main reason for this. So let us try to solve using the second technique, where we have solved using the value of VAO or VON. So I am directly calculating the value. VON will be equal to VRN into YR plus VYN into YY plus VBN into YB divided by YR plus YY plus YB. So we should know the value of what is VRN, VYN and VBN. So I can calculate my value of VRN. VRN is the phase voltage. That means this is 400 divided by root 3 at an angle of minus 30 degrees, because we know the phase voltage lags behind the line voltage by an angle of 30 degrees in the case of star connection. Or we have proved that the line voltage leads the phase current by 30 degrees, because the line voltage I am taking as reference, so this will become minus 30 degrees. So similarly, the value of VYN will be equal to 400 by root 3 at an angle of minus 150 degrees, and VCN will be equal to 400 by root 3 at an angle of minus 270 degrees, because it is lagging by 30 degrees behind the line value. So now how to calculate the value of YR, YY and YB. So this value of YR will be equal to 1 by ZR. So 1 by ZR means 1.8.94 at an angle of 63.4. So this will become 0.11 at an angle of minus 63.4. Similarly, you can calculate YY will be equal to 1 by ZY. This will be 0.2 at an angle of minus 53.1. Similarly, the value of YB will be equal to 1 by ZB. ZB is 25 at an angle of 53.1. So this becomes 0.04 at an angle of minus 53.1 degrees. So from this I can substitute here and get my value of VON. So if you substitute, I am directly writing the answer. You will get the numerator will be equal to 36.68 at an angle of 182.66. You can please cross verify. I have already calculated this. 0.35 at an angle of 56.2 degrees. Or this will become equal to 104.8 at an angle of 238.86 degrees. So VON came. So when the VON came, I can calculate my respective phase voltages. How to calculate this? We have already seen VRO is equal to VRN minus VON. You have to take the vector difference of these things, or sorry, phasor difference of these things. So 230.94 at an angle of minus 30 minus 104.8 at an angle of 230.86. So if you subtract this, you will get 253.89 at an angle of minus 5.67. Similarly, you can calculate VYO. VYO will be equal to VYN minus VON. This will become 230.94 at an angle of minus 150 minus 104.8 at an angle of 230.86. So if you calculate this, you will get as 149.2 at an angle of 189.68 volts. Similarly, VBO will be equal to VBN minus VON. This will be equal to 325 at an angle of 80.7 degrees. So once your voltages are obtained, I can calculate my respective phase currents easily. This will be VRO divided by ZR. Similarly, IY can calculate VYO divided by ZY, or this I can calculate as VRO into YR or VYO into YY. Using any technique you can calculate. If you calculate this, you will get it as 28.41 at an angle of minus 67.07. This will become 29.85 at an angle of 136.58. And the value of IB is coming as 13 at an angle of 27.6 degrees. You can see the current are proportional to the values of the impedances only. So whichever has higher impedance, the current is less. Whichever has less impedance, the current is more. But if you take the phase voltages, the voltage you can see, whichever has a more impedance, more voltage is dropped across it. Whichever have less impedance, less voltage is dropping across that. That means the phase voltages of the different phases are changing. So this concept is called as the shifting neutral concept in a star connection. That's why in order to avoid the shifting neutral, only option available to me, connect the two neutrals together. That is the reason if you take in your household, always the neutral point will be available, that neutral will be connected to the neutral of your transformer. So that, because we know in our house, the three phases will not be loaded in an balanced way. So when the three phases are not balanced, automatically voltages will change. So different phases will get different voltages. There is a chance your equipment may damage. That is the reason we have to be cautious. Always neutral point should be connected. I hope the star connection is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.